Hi students, this is Viswanath, chemistry faculty for NEET and IIT exams. In last class we completed 15 questions regarding to IIT mains exam held on 24th February 2021. Now see the next question. In contact process, impurities of arsenic are removed by. Contact process means in this H2SO4 is manufactured. In that process, arsenic element is considered as impurities. To remove these impurities, which substance is suitable? See this. Here, arsenic particle, arsenic element forms negative sole. Arsenic negatively charged sole. So this negatively charged sole is coagulated by Fe3 plus ions present in FeOH thrice. So option B is the answer for this. Arsenic impurities in contact process are removed by FeOH thrice. Option B is the answer. Next. According to Bohr's model of atom, identify the correct matching. Based on Bohr's theory in atomic structure, we should find out the correct matching. Kinetic energy, velocity, frequency, Coulombic force related expressions are given. Now find out the correct one. See this. First one, P, kinetic energy Ke equal to negative of total energy. What is the total energy expression? Minus 13.6 into Z square by N square electron volt. Already here negative sign is there, then we can get 13.6 into Z square by N square electron volt. Understand carefully. Here energy expression is minus 13.6 into Z square by N square electron volt. But here already negative sign is there. So negative into negative, positive. Then we can get minus into minus plus, so we can get 13.6 into Z square by N square electron volt. From this we can conclude that kinetic energy is directly proportional to Z square by N square. Next, Q. What is the Q? Velocity is directly proportional to N by 2. Okay, check it. Take the velocity expression. Velocity V equal to, what is the formula? Final expression, 2.188 into 10 power 6 into Z by N meter per second. From this, we can write velocity is directly proportional to Z by N. But here in the question, they give N by 2. That is wrong. Next. R. What is R expression? Frequency is directly proportional to Z cube by N cube. Check it whether it is correct or wrong. See this one. Frequency nu equal to, what is the formula? Frequency nu equal to V by 2 pi R. Frequency nu equal to V by 2 pi R. V is the velocity, R is the radius of the electron in the Bohr's orbit. Now substitute velocity expression and radius expression in this. Here velocity expression, here radius expression. Then we can get frequency nu equal to, what is the velocity expression? Velocity V equal to 2 pi z e square by n h 2 pi z e square by n h radius or expression, what is that? N square h square by n square h square by 4 pi square m z e square. So these are the two expressions. Velocity v equal to 2 pi z e square by n h, radius r equal to n square h square by 4 pi square m z e square. Now substitute these two in frequency, then we can get this one. See here, 2 pi z e square by 2 pi z e square by n h, 2 pi z e square by n h into here in the denominator 2 pi is there into what is our radius expression, n square h square, n square h square, this denominator comes to the numerator, then 4 pi square m z e square. So understand carefully, in place of r we are substituting this one, then finally we can get this one. From this 2 pi get cancelled, frequency nu equal to 4 pi square m z square e power 4 divided by n cube into h cube. Then we can write frequency is directly proportional to z square by n cube. Frequency is directly proportional to z square by n cube. But in the question, what they give? Z cube by n cube. That is wrong. Actually, it should be z square by n cube. So this one. Now, yes. What is the expression? Coulombic force, see here, Coulombic force is directly proportional to 1 by r square. F is directly proportional to 1 by r square. That implies F is proportional to r, means what is the formula? This one, n square h square by 4 pi square m z e square. So substitute that one, n square h square by 4 pi square m z e square whole power 2. Then we can get, what is that? F is directly proportional to, it comes to the numerator, 8 pi power 4 m square z square e power 4 by n power 4 h power 4. Okay students, so from this we can write F is directly proportional to z square by n power 4. This one. So force is directly proportional to square of the, inversely proportional to square of the distance, 1 by r square. R means radius. Then n square radius expression is this one. From this we can get finally F is directly proportional to z square by n power 4. But in the question they give Coulombic force is directly proportional to n power 4 by z square. Coulombic force is directly proportional to n power 4 by z square. That is wrong. Only expression P, kinetic energy, is correct. Remaining Q or S, they give wrong relations. So what is the answer? Option B is the answer. Only P is the correct one. So this question little bit difficult because we have to remember these expressions, but to get more marks, we have to do hard work. That means we have to remember these type of difficult expressions. Okay. See the next one. Compare the wavelength in flame test for LICL, NaCl, KCl, RBCl and CSCl. Now, lithium chloride's compound is given. Lithium chloride, sodium chloride, rubidium chloride, cesium chloride, their related wavelengths in flame test. Based upon the color exhibited by these compounds in flame test, we can estimate the related wavelength. Already in alkali group elements, we learned colors exhibited by alkali metals. Sodium, yellow color. Lithium, crimson red color. See here, I will give a simple tabular form. Metal. And next one is color. Metal and color exhibited by that. Metal means lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. So sodium means yellow, it is very familiar, and potassium means violet, and this one means crimson red, rubidium red violet, red violet, cesium blue. So you may get it out, how can we remember all these colors? But we have to remember, that's all, because only for these elements these type of colored based questions may come. So practice it to remember these colors. Now say this, Wibgr, already we know that violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. From violet to red, wavelength increases. Okay. Now, based on this Wibgr, we can understand or we can estimate the related wavelength for these alkali metals. Yellow color means, in numericals also, we can see the wavelength value, that is 589.2. 589.2 nanometers, approximately 580. Now come to the next one. Blue means, based on this Wibgr, what is the wavelength? Less or more? Less. So this is least wavelength in these colors. Next, red color means, what is the red color wavelength? Highest wavelength. Highest wavelength. So in the given values, what is the highest wavelength? 780. That means rubidium exhibits that value, 780.0 nanometers. And least wavelength exhibited by blue, that means blue color, that is cesium metal. In this, least wavelength is 455.5 nanometer. So its value 455.5 nanometer. And what is the remaining one? Crimson red. Already we got three options, three elements wavelengths: sodium, rubidium, cesium. Based on these three, we can guess lithium wavelength, because in the options PQRS only four compounds are given: sodium, rubidium, cesium, we got it. So from that, lithium we can guess. Now say this, sodium Q related to second one, 589.2. see here, Q related to second one, P, R, yes. And rubidium related to 780, R 4, cesium 455, yes 5. See this, R 4, yes 5. Then what about P? What is the suitable option? for our values? Option A. That means lithium exhibits wavelength. What is the wavelength? 670.8 nanometer. So P1, Q2, R4, S5. This is the suitable option for these elements based upon the colors and wavelengths. Then what is the answer? Option A is the answer. Okay, students, for this, option A is the answer. Thank you.